We all come to a story with hopes and expectations, looking for an answer. Sometimes it would be better to live with that hope without ever knowing the full story. In a horror story, there are only victims and monsters. And the trick is not to end up as either. But trapped by the genre, we are all ripped to pieces along the way. This is not the story I hoped it would be. This is not the ending I wanted. This story will eat us alive. This story is a monster. And monsters wear many faces.
This trip might take a little longer than I thought. I'm sorry I've been gone so much lately, Logan.
Oh my god, Mom, it's not your fault. People get all murdery. What happened?
Just work stuff.
Right. Well, Dad and I are just watching the latest episode of Night Springs here. Mom, it's so good.
No spoilers! I'll let you get back to the show. You were supposed to wait and watch with me. I love you both.
This is what happens when you go on work trips, Mom. Love you too. And say hi to Casey. Tell him to stop brooding so much.
Logan? I will. Bye, kiddo. Logan thinks you should try cheering up.
Snarky kid. Wonder where she gets that from.
It can't be a coincidence that another body turns up just as we arrive in town. Feels like the killer's leaving us a message.
I'm glad you're on this case with me, Anderson. It's right up your alley. You should take lead. Think of me as the backup.
Okay. Any words of advice?
Nothing that would cheer anyone up. Here we are, Cauldron Lake.
Time to get to work. deputy was supposed to be here to show us to the crime scene. There's the car, so where's the deputy?
Eaten by a bear? I'll check out that map. Worth memorizing before we get swallowed up by the trees.
I should take a look at that map. I think I hear someone.
I'm not walking all the way back.
Could be our deputy.
I can go take a look.
The Federal Bureau of Control? That's a new one. Toxic volcanic gas, huh?
The FBC is an obscure branch. It only shows up for unusual cases.
Well, what's so unusual about volcanic gas?
Beats me.
Locked. They really don't want people coming in here. I need to head back.
Hey, over here. Hey there. Agent Casey, right? Sheriff Breaker said you'd be coming by to take over the case.
You're half right. Anderson?
Saga Anderson, I'll be leading this case. Seems you already know my partner, Alex Casey.
Shoot. Sorry about that, ma'am. I'm Deputy Mulligan. I just figured that, you know, that,
Where are those damn feds gonna show up, Mulligan?
Federal agents right here, Thornton. My partner, Thornton, down at the crime scene. He's not what you call the sharpest axe in the shed.
Were there any witnesses?
Yeah, a couple out-of-towners. I wonder what they were doing sneaking around the woods at night.
Mention the city folk. It's pretty suspicious.
Not that we have anything against city folk, cried Thornton. But don't worry. Sheriff Breaker took them back to town a while ago.
What can you tell us about the crime scene?
I was getting to that, Thornton. Well, we reckon there are some organs that are currently outside the victim's person when they should be, well, you know, inside.
I want to see the body. How do we get there?
Oh, sure, that's real simple. Just through the hole in the fence, down the hill towards the lake, around the old convenience store. You can't miss it. Everything's been closed since the area was fenced off. The store, the campground, all of it.
Hey, Mulligan, tell them I'm here, waiting. I'll show them around.
They got it, Thornton. Shut up, Thornton. They can still hear you.
I'm just saying. You know I'm usually a calm person. Yoga, 3 times a week. But these goddamn city folk always think they know everything. It gets on my fucking nerves.
Shut up. Shut up. Shut up.
For fuck's sake.
Before we get to the crime scene, there's time to review the facts of the case so far. Make sure I'm seeing the clues clearly. The Mind Place. My version of the Mind Palace technique. To sift through clues and work the case. Building the Mind Place again for each case. Using each field office as a model in my head. The facts are on the board. everything we know about the previous murders. Worth taking another look.
I see you're already hard at work, Anderson. Close to cracking it?
We're just getting started. Let's head down the hill to the crime scene.
Fucking nature. Gives me a headache. It's too much sky.
Hey, Casey. You putting me in charge. Why now?
Look, Anderson, you're a better detective than I am. You've cracked cases that had the rest of us baffled. I don't want to slow you down.
Are you thinking of retiring? You know what happens to cops who say this is their last case.
Mm-hmm. Real funny, Anderson.
I'll be back in a second.
Roger.
I need bolt cutters.
Good to see you still in one piece, Anderson. Forest can be a dangerous place.
Stairs are out. You okay to jump down?
I'm not that old.
I think I saw something. It'll only take a minute.
I'll wait here.
Welcome back, Anderson.
Not a bad place to get murdered.
If getting back to nature is your thing.
Damn. Should have brought an umbrella.
I like the rain. The only thing around here that feels like home.
You think the local law had the sense to put up a tarp?
If they did, next coffee's on me.
I'll look around. See you in a bit.
Take your time.
Can't go any further. Water's too deep. Deputy Thornton, I take it.
That's me, at your service, ready to get this case solved. Now the body's behind this door. Come on, I'll show you.
Did you get lost, Anderson?
So, FBI, huh? That's so cool. Hunting down psycho serial killers and shootouts with the mob?
You forgot the UFO cover-ups.
What? Those are real? You guys hiring?
Let's just see this body, shall we?
A creepy twig sculpture? Hey there, Mr. Deer. You remind me of a dream I had. Wonder what's inside. I should take a look around for a way to open this thing.